स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्ताम्बूमधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नकाः तमर्थम् अवलम्बन्ते ये अङ्गिनं ते गुणास्मृताः अङ्गाश्रितास्तु अलङ्काराः मन्तव्याः कटकादिवत् सो वि सा द डेफिनेशन् अण्ड् द डिफरेन्स् बिट्वीन् गुण एण्ड् अलङ्कार वेर् वि सा दट् गुणास् आर् दोस् विच् आर् तम् अर्थम् अवलम्बन्ते ये अङ्गिनं तम् अङ्गिनं रसम् अर्थम् अवलम्बन्ते ते एव गुणाः स्मृताः अङ्गाश्रिताः शब्द अर्थ रूप अङ्ग आश्रिताः ये अलङ्काराः ते कटकादिवत् ये तिष्ठन्ति ते अलङ्काराः इति मताः दट् इस् द डेफिनेशन् दट् वि सा वि आल्सो स्टार्टेड् वित् माधुर्यं बट् ऐ थाट् बिफोर् वि गो इन् टु दट् we will do the gunam part in detail see this is once we get this picture properly then it will be easier to approach the second year in kavya prakasham where we have the guna prakaranam or anything for that matter even any in a kavyam so to know what the guna swarupam is what happens there and how it applies for each and every rasam so I thought we will just go into that a little bit more in detail you can pick and choose for your exam this is like this doesn't this is not involving your exam as such but it will be useful to understand and appreciate kavyam and alankara shastram that way see in the kavya darsham we find that dandin has given 10 guna which is both shabdalankara shabda guna and artha guna so his view of looking at gunas is that which is the quality of the word and the quality of the artham but he does not say it because there was no rasadhwani then or the concept of dhwani and all that so the placement of the gunam was not treated in a very correct manner by the earlier alankarikas and Anandavardhana more than Anandavardhana it is Abhinava Gupta who has given it a beautiful place and established given it its proper place where it should be as far as kavyam is concerned and as far as the dhwani is concerned so slesh of prasada samata madhuryam sukumaratha arthavyakti rudaratvam ojah kanti samadhaya these are the 10 different gunas that dandin has said but most of the times later period after the dhvani and the post dhvani alankarika who are dhvani followers have accepted only 3 gunas which is madhuryam ojah and prasada so I've taken some quotations from atika for So Lochanam has a commentary called Balapriya and there is a tika upon that which is called the Divyanjanam where he very clearly beautifully gives the karyabhutam and karanabhutam so madhuryam is the hetu madhuryam is the karyam and the hetu bhutam are there are 3 different states of the mind which gives rise to these guna and these gunas contribute to the rasam that's how the process goes so he says prachinaah श्लेषादीन् दश शब्दगुणान् तानेव च तावतः लक्षणभेदेन भिन्नान् अर्थगुणान् निजगतुः सो द सेम् 10 केन् ऐदर् बि वेन् इट् इस् फोकस्ड् आन् शब्द आर् वेन् इट् इस् फोकस्ड् आन् अर्थ इट् केन् बि अ शब्दगुण आर् एन् अर्थगुण बेस्ड् आन् दिस् ओन्ली यु विल् फैण्ड् इन् प्रतापरुद्रियम् हि डिवैड्स् इट् इन् टु 24 गुणस् वेर् देर् आर् शब्दगुण एन् अर्थगुण But Srimad Anandavardhanacharya, Abhinavagupta, Mammata, Vishwanatha Prabhrutayaha, Dhimantaha, Madhurya, Oja, Prasada, Ojaha, Prasada, Abhidhana, Rasamatra Nishthana, Trina Eva Gunana, Nirnidhe. So they have the Nirnayam Chakruhu. So they have established that there can be only 3 gunas. And that is rasamatra nishtana. They are only based upon the rasam, which is madhuryam, guna, ojaha and prasadam. Tathahi, tesham matam, tesham Abhinava Guptanam, Anandavardhanacharyanam, dhvani and post-dhvani. Their matam is, sahridayanam nava rasa charvana janyaha tisraha dhashaha bhavanti. It is only based on these mind states that you are looking at gunam, that you are going to name those gunas. There are three states that the mind has. There is a chitta vritti visheshaha. What are those three? Sahridayanam nava rasa charvana janyaha. When they are experiencing new different rasa, navarasam, the nine types of rasa, right? Shringara to shantam. When they are experiencing those nine types of rasas, there are three states of mind that arise. One is druti, next is second one is vistaraha, third one is vikasaha. To explain it further, he says, drutihi nama sahridaya anubhava sakshika sukumaraha chittavritti visheshaha. Everything is a chittavritti vishesha. Some thought or a vikaram in the mind, in a different transformation of the mind. So the druti is sahridaya anubhava sakshika sukumaraha. Only those connoisseurs can understand, they experience it, and they experience that softness. Only the people of taste can experience the softness that is there in it. Then lochana salila, the moment you read certain shlokas, like, you know, advaitam sukadukka yoho, when you are reading it, or when you are trying to explain it, when you are trying to understand the import of certain shlokas, automatically, without your realization, your eyes tear up. Lochana salilam, pulakadi, romancham, anubhavita shaurya krodhadi udbhavita deeptatva vismaya hasadi janita vikshepa ananubiddha. It is not connected with shaurya krodha, the deeptatvam or the prakashatvam that is associated with shaurya krodha, etc. There is no vismayam, no hasam. There is just that melting of that heart. That chitta vritti, you see, your heart just melted. You don't know what to, that is druti. Sahridaya anubhava sakshika sukumaraha. Sacha shringara karuna shantebhyaha jayate. Shanta, so again, according to Abhinav Gupta, there are certain other divisions also. Generally, it is accepted that in shringaram and karunam, there is druti, definitely. Shantam depends on what the vibhava is. What is the source of that shantarasa? If the chanta, it is very subjective, right? Shringara Karuna itself is not, may not be as subjective, because the loss of some person is equal to everybody. But what gives rise to Shantam may be different. So depends on the Vibhavam. The moment you see a battlefield, you feel everything, like Arjuna felt Shantarasam there. You know, he felt he has to do his duty, and it came from that. Someone who stays at the outside of an Abhisarika's house, it is a different, that Shringaram can be a Shantarasa Utpadaka. So depending on the Vibhavam, it will change. Hence we will just say Drutihi Shringara Karuna Shantebhyaha Jayate. Next is Vistaraha. This is another type of Chittavritti Vishesha, where Druti Virodhini, it is exactly opposite to drutam, where the manasi yalagaradunu solluvom drutina avade, there is a softening of the heart and it just flows. No, tamil la da adu alaga irukum yalagaradungiradhu. Vistaraha nama, whereas vistara druti virodhini, it is opposite to that. Deepti aparaparyaya, vistara is synonymous to the word deepti. This deepti is the word that Anandavardhana uses to explain Ojoguna. So deepti aparaparyaya jigisha, when you want to win over someone, there is an, he says it's an expansion of the heart. You feel like it is, you can do much more than what you can. That sort of a, the physical reactions to that is you immediately lift your shoulders up and you feel, you know, you can win over the entire world. That sort of a feeling is Vistaraha. So Vigisha, Atyanta Tyaga Icha, the moment you want to forsake something, there is one Vairagyam Cholra. It's Tamil Vairagyam that I'm saying, not Sanskritam. So Vairagyam means there is a steadfastness that you have to forsake certain things. So Atyanta Tyaga Icha, Vadha Avadhika. Vadha Avadhika means it can result in killing. Vadha Avadhika, that is also possible. Prayasadi Karini. So an effort which can result in killing is also this chittavritti. Any action for any of these four or five actions, jigisha, atyanta tyaga iccha, vadha avadika prayasa adi, you can include whatever you want. In order to act, there is a certain kachit antahkaranasya vrittihi bhavati. That vritti is called vistaraha. So think of an enemy you want to win over, then you the effort that you take, the transformation of that heart, the transformation of that mind, the thoughts that arise in your mind is like an expansion that is there. It's like a vistaraha. There's no other way to say it. Next is vikasaha api hasya adbhuta bhayanakebhyaha jayamanaha cheto vritti visheshaha eva. So vikasaha is in the malaradengro, blooming. It's neither druti nor is it just a harsh understanding or that harsh emotion. This is vikasa is a more milder version, which is in between the two of them. So vikasaha api, that is found in hasirasa, adbhuta and bhayanakebhyaha jayamanaha. When you encounter certain things which can induce that rasa in you, then you have the chittavritti visheshan, that is, there is vikasaha. Hasye vadanasya vikasaha bhavati. When you are, when it is hasya rasam, your face blooms. Adbhute lochanasya. You see something surprising, immediately you open your eyes wide and say, oh my God, this is so beautiful. The first reaction, these are all the indications that are there physically that you see. So bhayanakasya, bhayanake gamanasya vikasa ropaha. You have to run away from that place, correct? You want to, that is the chitta vritti. Whether you do it or not, that is another thing. Or you can even sankocha ropaha is also there, but you want to escape from that situation. That is even more. That feeling is prompted. Tadrishaha vikasa rupaha anubhavaha samanubhuyate. Anubhavaha are the physical actions that accompany this vikasa, which is a chitta vritti. Okay? So, avastha atraya hetu bhutaha eva madhurya ojav prasada abhidanaha gunaha. So, these three qualities, guna, kavya guna, are responsible for druti, vistara, vikasa. So you read a kavyam, and if the kavya has these guna visheshaha, then it will respectively give rise to druti, vistara or vikasa in the minds of the sadhritaya or the reader. It should, because it is based upon the rasam that it wishes to convey, that the kavyam wishes to convey. Sariya? This is I found this as a nice introduction to understand the placement of gunam. So now we'll look at Shringaram based on this. Then Madhuryam being Chittasya Dravatvam will fit even more beautifully. So Shringarayeva Madhuraha Paraf Prakhladano Rasaha Tanmayam Kavyamashritya Madhuryam Pratitishthati. Shringaraya eva rasantara apekshaya madhuraha. Compared to any other rasam, Shringara is the most sweetest one, where prakhlada hetutvata, it gives a santosham in our minds. Tad prakashana paraha shabdarthataya kavyasya. Kavyam is based on shabda and artha. Tad prakashanataya, madhura prakashanataya, athava shringara prakashanataya, anything. So madhuryam is, he takes it as synonymous to shringaram. Shringaram cannot exist without madhuryam. That's how it is. Whether it is madhuryam of shabda or artha, it's okay. Whatever it may be. But tat prakashana paraha shabdarthataya kavyasya saha madhurya lakshanaha gunaha. Kavyasya, because the kavyam is based on tat prakashana, madhurya prakashana para shabdarthataya. It has shabda and artha which is capable of giving us that madhuram, or it has that madhura gunam in it, and it is able to give us that druti in our mind. So that is called madhuryam. श्रव्यत्वं पुनः ओजसः अपि साधारणं. श्रव्यत्वं मीन्स् इट् इस् नैस् टु हियर्, देर् इस् अ ब्यूटिफुल् फ्लो आफ् लाङ्ग्वेज् दट् इस् देर् इन् आल् गुणम्. इट् शुड् इट्स् ए देर् इस् नो पायिण्ट् इन् रैटिङ्ग् अ कठिनं श्लोकं विच् नोबडी केन् अण्डर्स्टाण्ड्, नार् इस् देर् अ फ्लो टु दट् श्लोकम्. यस् द मीटर् इस् बीन् फालोड्, द वर्ड्स् आर् करेक्ट्, द व्याकरण शुद्धं, येट् दे शुड् कनेक्ट्. There should be an automatic flow of one word to another word. You can't, only when you study, it is only by anubhavam that you will know, only by experience. Satatha cha, shringare vipralambakye karune cha prakarshavat, madhuryam ardratam vyati yataha tatra adhikam manaha. Shringare vipralambakye, so shringare samboga shringare, vipralambakye vipralamba shringare karune, that is how we understand. And then in the vritti he says vipralamba shringara karunayoho tu madhuryameva prakarshavate. In specifically, maybe in sambhoga shringaram you can have something a little bit different, but it can be a little bit madhuram, but vipralamba and karuna cannot be devoid of madhuryam. It has to have madhuryam, because that gives the soul to the poetry there. सहृदय हृदय आवर्जन अतिशय निमित्तत्वात् इट् इस् द रीजन् फार् अट्राक्टिङ्ग् द मैण्ड्स् आफ् सहृदय. ओके, एण्ड् वि सा इन् द लोचनम् यस्टर्डे हौ मधुरः हि शर्करादिरसः मधुर टु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् वाट् माधुर्यम् इस् द मोमेण्ट् यु पुट् शर्करा इन् युवर् मौत् विवेकिनः वा अविवेकिनः वा स्वस्थस्य वा आतुरस्य वा झटिति अभिलषणीयः भवति. It becomes immediately, we respond to it very quickly, more than the others. It's a sweet is, I think only people who have a sweet tooth will understand this. Maybe he is like that. Now, the aspect why he says madhuryam is important is, go back to Kavya Prakasham, where he said, kanta sammitataya upadesha yuje. Prabhu Sammitam is Veda. Mitra Sammitam is Itihasa Puranadi. Kanta Sammitataya. Kanta Sammitataya means the moment a lady enters there, it is that Madhuryam that she brings within. So a Kavya's, the purpose of a Kavyam is to give us an Upadesham in a very palatable manner, in a more, not palatable, but more pleasing manner. That is why he talks of madhuryam as the first guna. Next is ojaha. Ojasaha saraudradayaha rasaha deeptya lakshyante kavyavartinaha. Deepti compared to that vistaraha, it is the vikasa of the mind. So tadvyakti hetu shabdarthau ashritya ojo vyavasthitam. रौद्रादयः रसाः, रौद्रादयः हि रसाः दीप्त्या लक्ष्यन्ते काव्यवर्तिनः. दोस् रसास् विच् आर् इन् द काव्यं, रौद्र एक्सेट्रा. रौद्र एक्सेट्रा मीन्स् यु हाव् रौद्र वीर एण्ड् अद्भुत अकार्डिङ्ग् टु लोचन. अद्भुतं केन् आल्सो बी देर् केन् आल्सो बी माधुर्यम् इन् अद्भुतं. यु काण्ट् हाव् ओन्ली दीप्ति देर्, because again it depends on what the vibhavam is, what the alambana vibhava is and the uddipana vibhavas are. So adbhuta rasam, when you are looking at vamanavataram, ulagalanda perumal is lifting his leg and you're imagining that scene, then it is one veera, he is winning over bali and then the vibhava is a veera vibhava janitaha. So you're not maybe shantam, but I look at it more as veeram, because he is showing his power over bali there and he wants to control bali there. So that is an adbhuta rasam, from where so deepti will work there. Whereas if you're looking at adana sayankale vanante kusimita shayane, it's if you're looking at a scene of rasakrida, Imagine. Then there is Madhuryam and Adbhutam. That Adbhutam is more of a Shringara Vibhava Janitaha. Then there is more of Madhuryam there. So very, very dependent on, that is why Vibhava and Anubhava are all extremely important. And Bharata's Rasa Sutram also says Vibhava Anubhava Vyavachari Samyogat Rasa Nishpatti. You can't just treat it as this will give rise to this and this will give rise to this. You can never keep it in boxes and understand. So, but whereas Raudram and Veeram, you can't have Madhuryam there. There is no point in looking at Madhuryam at all because it is very clearly boxed into Deepti or Ojoguna. So Raudradayaha Rasaha Param Deeptim Ujjvalatam Janayanti. Iti Lakshanaya Teyeva Deeptihi Iti Uchyate. Deeptiriti Uchyate, you can either say Uchyante or Uchyate because of the presence of word Iti. Iti Uchyate can also be connected, or you can say Teyeva Uchyante. If that Iti is not present, then it cannot be in singular. It's just a grammatical point. So it's okay. Raudradayaha Rasaha.
Thank you. Nana. தேங்க் யூ ரொம்ப நல்லா இருந்தது.
அது கன்ஃபியூஸ் ஆகும் பல சமயம், அதுக்காக ஜஸ்ட் மென்ஷன் இட் சார். தீப்தி தேயேவ தேயேவ ரசாஹ ச தீப்தி இது உச்சதே லக்ஷணயா. சோ ரசம் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு தீப்தி, விச் இஸ் த ஹேதுபூதம் இஸ் யுவர் ஓஜோகுணம். ஹி ஜஸ்ட் டேக்ஸ் மாதுரியம் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஆஸ் ஸ்ருங்காரம், ஸ்ருங்காரா ஏவ மதுரா Raudraha eva deeptihi. That's how it is. Okay, so which is the chittavritti vishesha. And then actually deepti is actually ojo gunam thane. Ama, sorry, idiyo pore. I just mentioned that Kavya Darsha's definition of ojo gunam because he only looks at shabdam, which is samasa bhuyastvam, etat gadyasya jivitam. And without ojo gunam, you cannot have gadyam. You need it, whether it is Shringara Rasam or Karuna Rasam. If there is a description, you will have Samasa Bhuyastvam and Ojo Gunaha Gadye Asti. It is not Dosham. There are also certain portions where if there is a conversation, like in Kadambari where she is talking, even in Kadambari where she is, Mahashweta is talking of how Pundarika has been taken away from, he is almost dead and... he is dead, but he will come back alive. There she is talking of how dejected she feels and she was going to commit suicide. Even there, it is a Karuna Rasam, and there he will use Samasam. But not Dirgha Samasam, but Madhyama Samasam. Not so much, but a little bit. And it is Gadyasya Jeevitam, whether it is Karuna Rasam or whatever it may be. So let's not look at too much of Gadyam here. I just mentioned it for you to keep that in background. It's not relevant as far as this goes. It'll be useful later. Adiptihi in Lochanam, he says, Pratipattuhu Hridaye Vistara Prajvalana Swabhava Deeptihi Saeva Raudradayaha Rasaha. That is, the same Deepti is Raudra Rasa. தத் பிரகாசன பரஹா சப்தா தீர்க சமாச ரச்சனா அலங்கிருதம் வாக்கியம் யதா. So the two things, ஓஜோ குணம் can be, we can understand ஓஜஸ் through சப்த ஆர் த்ரூ அர்த்தம். இஃப் வி ஆர் ட்ரைங் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஓஜஸ் த்ரூ சப்தம், இட் ஷுட் ஹாவ் தீர்க சமாச லாங் காம்பவுண்ட்ஸ். தீர்க சமாச ரச்சனா அலங்கிருதம் வாக்கியம் தத் பிரகாசன பரஹா சப்தா. தத் பிரகாசன தீப்தி பிரகாசன பரஹா அதுவா ரௌத்ராதி ரச பிரகாசன பரஹா ஓஜோ குண பிரகாசன பரஹா. இட்ஸ் பிகாஸ் இட் இஸ் ரசனிஷ்டம், வி மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் த டைம்ஸ் வி டாக் ஆஃப் இட் இன் த சேம் லக்ஷணயா. வி சே எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் த சேம். ஓகே, சோ டோன்ட் கெட் கன்ஃபியூஸ்ட் அபவுட் தட். நவ் திஸ் இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் த சப்தம் விச் இஸ் விச் ப்ராம்ப்ட்ஸ் தட் இன் அவர் மைண்ட். சஞ்சத்புஜ பிரமித சண்ட கதாபிகாத சஞ்சூர்ணிதோரு யுகலஸ்ய சுயோதனஸ்ய ஸ்தியானாவபத்த கன சோணித சோணபாணிஹி உத்தம் சயிஷ்யதி கசான்ஸ் தவ தேவி பீமஹ. ஹே தேவி திரௌபதி, பீமஹ தவ கசான உத்தம் சயிஷ்யதி. Bhima, Bhima will deck your hair, ornament, or, you know, he will tava keshana alankaroti. Uttam saishyati means he will tie it. Bhima is going to tie your hair, tava kachana, with his hand, panihi. This that sthyana avabaddha panihi is Bhima's adjective. So panihi with his hands, which is shona, red with the shonitam, the ghana shonitam with the thick blood, sthyana avabaddha, which is very you know, in it is not a flowing blood, but it is in chunks. So it is like he's decorating it with chunks of that. So of whose blood is this Suyodhanasya? Okay, let me. So Suyodhanasya, the blood of Duryodhana, whose Uru Yugalam, his thighs have been Sanchurnita, they've been made crushed with this gada. I will crush his thighs and take the blood from there, and I will tie your hair. I will definitely do that. This is Bhima Pratignya here in Veni Samhara. So chanchat bhuje bhuje bhimaha vegena svabhujau avartayati. So chanchat bhujam bhramita chandagada bhujayoho bhramanena chandagada api bhramitam. So the Bhramita Chandagada Abhigata Tayagadaya Abhigataha Tena Abhigatena Sanchurnita Uru Yugalaha Suyodhanaha. So the Tadrusha Suyodhanasya Shonita Shonipani Panihi Shona Panihi Bhimaha Tavakachana Uttam Saishyati. I'm going to read out from the Lochanam, which the entire section in Lochanam is so beautiful that let's go through that. Chanchadhyam Vega, are you able to see it? I hope you're. Do I have to zoom in a little bit more? Tereda.
Little bit zoom in, Akka.
Okay. Is that fine?
Yeah, thank you.
Okay. So we'll starting from here. Chanchat iti Chanchadhyam. वेगात् आवर्तमानाभ्यां भुजाभ्यां भ्रमिता या इयं चण्डा दारुणा गदा यया तया यः अभितः सर्वतः ऊर्वोः घातः तेन. सो अभितः ऊर्वोः घातः. हि इस् यु नो वर्लिंग हिज गदा एंड इज हिटिंग दैट विथ जस्ट वन स्ट्रोक. अभितः मीन्स The you should imagine the expanse of that gada and his uru, his thigh. So with just one hit, samyak churnitam, punar anuttana upahatam, punar anuttana. He cannot get up again. He's using so much of force that Duryodhana cannot get up again. Upahatam kritam uru yugalam yugapadeva urudvayam. Within in the, at the same moment, both of his thighs were just crushed by Bhima at that point. Will be. This is all in future, he is saying. Urudvayam yasya tam suyodhanam anadritya eva. That's why I did not say that before. Here he uses that Shashti Vibhakti as Shashti cha anadhare. Without even considering Duryodhana, who has been killed like this, whose thighs have been crushed like this. This is, you use Sati Saptami, right? Suyodhane, Suyodhanasya Uru Yugale Sanchurnite Sati Bhimaha De Tavakachana Uttam Saishyati. So like Sati Saptami, if you want to say that you're not, you're ignoring that person in Sati Saptami, without even considering that thing, you're doing something else. So there you say Shashti Anadarecha. So you use Shashti instead of Saptami there. Some people say it is Sataha Shashti. Use Anadara Shashti, it is better to understand also, to remember also. So here, the Suyodhanam Anadritya Eva, without considering Duryodhana, without even looking at him for a second time, you know, he may come back and attack, right? There is a possibility there. With just one hit, he is not going to just fall off, but he did. Bhima has so much of confidence in his action that with just one swing of that gada he can crush Duryodhana. So tathavidam tam suryo suyodhanam anadritya eva स्थानेन आश्यानतया न तु कालान्तरशुष्कतया. He didn't wait. The moment, he will not wait. Immediately, as soon as he killed or hit him, he will take that blood which is fresh. Sthyana. Ashyana. Ashyana means it is still thick. It's not flowing, but it is thick. So, natu kalantara shushkataya. It is not something which has been dried and become thick. It was flowing and then it is dried. No, it is with the flesh portions, he's saying. Oh, the way he describes is so beautiful. Hastabhyam. Kalantara, natu kalantara shushkataya. Avabaddham hastabhyam. So it is in his hands, tadrisha hastabhyam, avigalat rupam. It's not flowing. Atyantam abhyantarataya ghanam. Because you can take it from the inside portion of that thigh. Imagine. Huh? So it is so thick, it seems. Not from just a small scratch and there is blood. Natu rasamatra swabhavam yat shonitam rudhiram. Tena shonau lohitau pani yasya saha bhimaha. Atayeva sa bhimaha katarat trasadai. Why there is raudra rasam here more than veera rasam? Because he can induce kataratvam, trasam. He will make other people feel like a coward and they will feel fear. So katarat trasadai bhimaha is your main point here. Tava yasyaha tat tad apamana jatam kritam devi anuchitam. He addresses her as Devi. You should be treated like such a, you know, kulakrama agata kulastri eva, but you were treated with so much of apamanam, which was Devi anuchitam. Tad apamana jatam kritam devi anuchitam api tasyaha tava kachan uttam sayishyati. I will uttamsa vataha. Uttamsa means like a chudamani. Chudamani is uttamsam. So these parts of that Suyodhana Uru Yugalam will be like a red flowers, it seems. Venitvam apaharan. He will remove her, you know, if she was trying to wear it in a veni, like a braid. Kula kalatra khili, apaharan kara vichyuta shonita shakalaihi lohita kusuma apidena iva yojayishyati iti utpreksha. So tava kachan uttamsayishyati means uttamsaiva karoti. I will make it as if it is an alankara, red flowers on your hair. I will decorate it like that, he says. Yo, I didn't know that there was so much of meaning into the shlokam until I read Lochana. Devi ityanena kula kalatra khilikara smarana karina krodhasya eva uddipana vibhavatvam kritam iti na atra shungara shanka kartavya. Devi, when he is saying, you know, there is not even one bit of shungaram there when Bhima addresses Draupadi as Devi, my lady. No. That devitvam also is to show that kula kalatra, she is the family, she is like the light of that family, right? So kula kalatram, wife, khilikara smarana karina. He has destroyed that a person who is supposed to be worshipped and honored. She was made to come to a sabha in such a humiliated fashion, right? So he wants to remind people that she is fit to be a devi. Yet she faced such an apamanam. So that is a krodhasya uddipana vibhava. Na atra shungara shunka. Suyodhanasya cha anadaranam dvitiya gada ghata ghata danadi anudyamaha. He does not make any effort to hit him second time. He doesn't have to because he's already gone, almost gone there. Duryodhana is gone, so he doesn't have to go there. So he ignores Duryodhana very clearly. He will ignore Duryodhana and move on to tying her hair. Sacha sanchurnita natu abhigatattvam. That is, see, abhigatena sanchurnitam is also there. You can't say it is, why does he have to repeat it? No punarukta dosham or anything here. Huh? So chan sanchurnita uru yugalena, from that we will understand that it is, he cannot move at all. He cannot get up. स्थानग्रहणेन द्रौपदी मन्युप्रक्षालने त्वरा सूचिता सो दट् फ्रेश्नेस् आफ् दट् ब्लड् इस् हि वाण्ट्स् टु इमीडियट्लि वैप् औट् दट् एङ्गर् दट् द्रौपदी इस् फीलिङ्ग् सो दट् दट् इस् दट् हरि इन् डूयिङ्ग् दट् दट् इस् सीन् इन् द वर्ड्स् स्थान एण्ड् शोणित फ्रेश् ब्लड् समासेन च सन्ततवेगवहनस्वभावात् actually that we'll stop with that so this one anyetu suyodhanasya sambandhi yaha styana avabaddham ghanam shonitam tena shonapanihi iti vyachakshate so you can say suyodhanasya shonitam it can connect like that like how I say if I say मम गृहकार्यम् अथवा और् यु नो मम पुत्रपुत्रः संथिङ्ग् लैक् दट् ऐ डोण्ट् नो हौ टु देर् वास् वन् एक्साम्पल् दट् हि वास् गिविङ्ग् चैत्रस्य गुरुकुलं गुरोः एव कुलं न तु चैत्रस्य कुलं सो इट् इस् सो चैत्रस्य गुरुः गुरोः कुलं यु केन् मेक् अ समासं लैक् दट् एण्ड् से चैत्रस्य गुरुकुलम् इन् द सेम् वे यु केन् से सुयोधनस्य शोणितपाणिः शोणशोणितपाणिः और् शोणितशोणपाणिः that can also happen but that is there is no chamatkaram there it's not it doesn't give that suyodhanam anadritya so much of dhvani that comes out of that anadra shashti which will be lost if we use the sambandha shashti maybe too much and beyond what is needed for your exam but it was too beautiful for me to let go of it at this point so I wanted to explain that चञ्चद्भुज भ्रमित चण्ड गदाभिघात सञ्चूर्णितोरुयुगलस्य सुयोधनस्य स्थानावबद्ध घन शोणित शोणपाणिः उत्तंसयिष्यति कचान् तव देवि भीमः दिस् इस् तत्प्रकाशनपरः दीर्घसमास रचना अलङ्कृतम् नेक्स्ट् इस् तत्प्रकाशनपरः च अर्थः अनपेक्षित दीर्घसमास रचनः प्रसन्नवाचक अभिधेयः यथा दिस् इस् दिस् इस् आल्सो फ्रम् वेणीसंहारम् The first shlokam chanchadbhuja bhramita was in first anka, prathama anka. This is in tritiya anka. So, yoyash shastram vibharti. Tat prakashana paraha arthaha. Tat deepti prakashana paraha arthaha. Anapekshita dirga samasa rachanaha. There need not be a dirga samasa. Long compound construct need not be present there. Prasanna vachaka abideyaha arthaha. So, abideyaha is the arthaha. That which is said, the primary meaning. The primary meaning which is brought out of vachaka words shabdas which are prasanna which are very clear or very nice to hear if someone does not understand even one word of sanskritam let's say the first shlokam will immediately give rise to an agitation in the mind there will be a vistara in the mind or a vikasa so it will give you know you want to do something about it whereas this one yoyash shastram vibharti swabhujaguru madaha pandavinam chamunam when you hear this shlokam it will be like parthaya pratibodhitam bhagavata narayana so there will be no difference between that but once you understand the meaning there will be an increase of that krodham as you go through the shlokam one by one the lines one by one योयः शस्त्रं बिभर्ति स्वभुजगुरुमदः पाण्डवीनां चमूनां योयः पाञ्चालगोत्रे शिशुरधिकवया गर्भजय्यां गतो वा योयस्तत्कर्मसाक्षी चरति मयि रणे यश्चयश्च प्रतीपः क्रोधान्धस्तस्य तस्य स्वयमपि जगताम् अन्तकस्य अन्तको वा अश्वत्थामा आफ्टर् हियरिङ्ग् दट् हिस् फादर् वास् कट् बै हिस् वास् बिहेडेड् बै दृष्टद्युम्न दिस् इस् द श्लोकम् हि सेस् यो यः whichever person whoever shastram bibarti whoever is carrying a weapon how is that person swabhuja guru madah pandavinam chamunam madhye in the army among the army of pandava anybody who has a garvam towards his swabhuja towards his arm one who is so proud of his arms guru madah one who has a great pride in his arm and shastram bibarti anybody who is carrying a shastram okay one next yoyah panchala gotre shishuhu adhikavaya garbhajayam gatova anybody whoever in the panchala clan panchala gotre shishuhu स्तनन्दयः चैल्ड् जस्ट् बोर्न् अधिकवयाः और् अ बाय् यूत् गर्भशय्यां गतो बिकास् यूत् वन्स् यु एण्टर् यौवनम् यु आर् रेडि फार् बेटल् इवन् एट् दि एज् आफ़् 16 यु आर् रेडि फार् बेटल् टुडे वि आर् यु नो pampering kids and keeping them at home. We are thinking of sending them not beyond the state, not beyond the country and all that. There, they will send their children to battlefields at the age of 16. They were ready. Adhikava. So that's why Adhikavayaha is Kaumaratvam and not Yabbanatvam. Shishuhu is a Stanandayaha, born child, 1 to 5. 5 to 10 or 15 is Adhikavayaha, Kaumaratvam. Next is Garbhashayyam Gatova. Even if the child is there in the womb, Garbhashayya, that person, the second one. Next is Yoyas Tat, because Panchala Gotram is where Drishtadyumna was born and he was the person responsible for his father's death, beheading. Just a death. It's not like he was taking up arms and he was fighting. He was ready to give up his arms and he had put down his bow and he was in meditation. At that point of time, Drishtadyumna came and beheaded him. So that is an apamana karma. So yoyas tat karma sakshi karna, etc. So pandavinam chamunam swabhuja guru madaha is Arjuna, etc. Those like Arjunas who are, you know, who think that they can win over the entire world with their prowess. And that's why they are carrying their weapons. Panchala Gotri is Drishtadyumna's family. Now here, yoyas tat karma sakshi. अस्मत् पक्षे अपि यो यः यः तत् कर्म साक्षी अस्ति इवन् इन् दि कौरव आर्मी इफ् देर् इस् अ पर्सन् हू हेस् विट्नेस्ड् इट् कर्ण कृप एक्सेट्रा मयि रणे चरति नेक्स्ट् इस् देर् इस् अ प्रोग्रेशन् हियर् सी द पाण्डव आर्मी वास् रेस्पान्सिबल् फार् फैटिङ्ग् अगेन्स्ट् मै फादर् दट् इस् द फस्ट् द नेक्स्ट् प्रोग्रेशन् इस् द वन् हू वास् डैरेक्ट्लि रेस्पान्सिबल् फार् दि आक्ट् हिस् क्लान् The next is Kritam Karitam Anumoditam. That's the three things are mentioned here. So anybody who is doing a mistake is not only the person who has made the mistake. Karitam, one who prompts the other person to do it. Anumoditam, after a person has done it, do it, you know. What you did was correct. If there is a person who is standing there and saying, yes, what you did was right, that person is also at fault. Because you are condoning that. So yoyas tat karma sakshi, one who is a witness to that action when Drona was beheaded. Next is yaschayas, this is the gradation where he moves on to a different level and he says, mayi rane charati sati, when I am in this battlefield, when I am roaming around in this battlefield, yaschayascha pratipaha, pratipaha viruddhena sthitaha, one who is against me in this, when I am in this battlefield, tasya tasya, for every one of them, not only these people, jagatam antakasya api, swayam api, jagatam swayam, jagatam antakasya api, krodhandaha aham, I'm blinded by my anger, antakasya api antakaha aham, I'm like the yama's yama, death for, I will even bring upon death for yama. That's the more you hear the words, and in a progression there is an increase of krodham, and at the end when he says I will even put an end to death himself, there is a paradeeptihi asti atra pritakbhutaihi eva kramat pritakbhutaihi arthaihi. So padat padam, each word is separate here. There is no dirgha samasatvam like in chanchatbhuja bramita. So there is a separate words are here. So atra pritakbhutaihi api अत्र पृथग्भूतैः एव क्रमात् विमृश्यमानैः अर्थैः वन्स् वि एनलैज् द मीनिङ्ग् आफ् ईच् एण्ड् एव्रि सेण्टेन्स् आर् ईच् एण्ड् एव्रि वर्ड् पदात् पदं फ्रम् वन् वर्ड् टु अनदर् वर्ड् वि अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् क्रोधः परां धाराम् आश्रितः इट् जस्ट् फ्लोस् लैक् यु नो रशिङ्ग् लैक् द क्रोधं दट् एङ्गर् इस् जस्ट् फ्लोयिङ्ग् इन् अ ब्यूटिफुल् मेनर् इति असमस् असमासतया असमस्तता एव even without samasam, even without long compounds, dipti nibandhana, prakashatvam there, ujjvalatvam is there. Ityadau dvayoho ojastvam, that is there in the text. So in both of these, either it is the shabda nishtam or the artha nishtam, there is that dipti or ojo gunam is present, and you can understand the rasam because of that. Enjoy the rasam because of that. Next is prasada gunaha. Samarpakatvam kavyasya yattu sarvarasan prati sa prasado guno gnyayaha sarva sadharana kriyaha. Prasadastu swachhata shabdarthayoho sacha sarvarasa sadharanaha gunaha sarva rachana sadharanaha cha vengyartha apekshaya eva mukhyataya vyavastitaha mantavyaha. Okay. Samarpakatvam kavyasya sarva rasan prati yettu samarpakatvam saeva prasadaha gunaha. The kavyasya, it is a sarva rasa sadharanaha, so it is common to all rasa, where there is a clarity between the shabda and the artha. Either there is an immediate understanding of, we all assume that we know sufficient Sanskritam, we have a Sanskritam knowledge for us to understand the Shabda and Artha immediately, jhatiti. Okay, so Shabda Artha Yoho Swachhata. Samarpakatvam he explains as Samyak Arpakatvam, how Sihridaya Samvadena Pratipatruna Prati, the one who tries to understand, the reader, Shrotruna Adava Patitruna Prati, Swatma Vashena Samyak samarpakatvam jhatiti vyaparakatvam. So that is immediately shushka kashta agni drishtantena. When you give the drishtantam in an example of how a dry wood, the moment a spark falls on it, it immediately catches fire. In the same way, hridaya samvadena, it is very close to the hridayam, whatever he feels. And one who wants to understand it, immediately can it can give rise to that meaning in the mind. That is prasada guna. That should be there in all rasas, no matter what. Whether it is bivatsam or what, you may not have that vocabulary knowledge. But once you have the Amarakosha, that's why we start off with Amarakosha lessons. Not that I started with, but Amarakosham is the first thing that people understand. So you have that vocabulary in your mind when you start reading kavyams. So samyak arpakatva means it gives rise to immediately gives rise, immediately there is a vyaparam in the mind that is there. Okay, so shabdartha yoho swachhata, or there is another drishtantam where you can say akalusha udaka drishtantena cha tad akalushyam prasannatvam nama sarvarasanam gunaha. So there is no mixing of either other words or dosham, or you don't have difficult understanding. You have to remember the nihata artham and all those dosham, where you're using the words in one particular sense and it is accepted popularly in Mahakavyam. And suddenly there is a word which is used in a completely different sense, which is either grammatically wrong or it is not at all popularly used in that sense. If I want to use the word lavanyam, I will only use it in the sense of beauty. I will never use it in the sense of saltiness. It is not prasiddham, correct? So that way, there should be a clarity of understanding, like how if water is very clear, and when we see clear water, it automatically reflects in our mind and we also feel very happy about it, right? That is the prasadaha, which gives rise to prasannatva. Sarvarasa sadharanam. Vyangyartha apekshaya mukhyataya vyavasthitaha mantavyaha. Now here, what he says is arthasya tavatuk samarpakatvam vyangyam pratyeva sambhavati na anyata shabdasya api swavachya arpakatvam nama kiyat alaukikam yena gunaha syat iti bhava. The prasada gunam is sarvarasa sadharanam. When we say that it is equal for all rasa, व्यंग्यार्थ अपेक्षया ओन्ली विद रेस्पेक्ट टू व्यंग्यार्थ आई एम टॉकिंग ऑफ इट्स इंपॉर्टेंस प्रसाद इट इज नॉट द क्लैरिटी ऑफ वर्ड्स एंड अर्थम इज नॉट फॉर द प्राइमरी वर्ड एंड प्राइमरी मीनिंग ओके फ्रॉम द प्राइमरी वर्ड द व्यंग्यार्थम ऑल्सो देर शुड बी अ क्लैरिटी द व्यंजक शब्द शुड बी एबल टू क्लियरली गिव मी दट व्यंग्यार्थम So that is the clarity that I'm talking about. So sarva rasa sadharanaha gunaha, sarva rachana sadharanascha, vyangyartha apekshaya eva. It is only with respect to the vyangyartha or the suggested word that I am talking about a clarity in shabda and word, artha. Iti vyavasthitaha iti mantavyaha. So as a conclusion, each rasam has specific guna. Right? So Shringare Madhuryam Asti, Karune Api Madhuryam Asti, Raudre Ojaha Vire Ojaha. These are all very specific and very clear cut. You can put it in box. Okay. Whereas Adbhutarasa, in Adbhutarasam, Vira Vibhava Janite Ojaha, this is not there in Lochanam or anything. It is just a classification that is there in, this Vira Adbhut, Vira Vibhava Janitam is there in Divyanjana Tika. The rest are all in Lochanam. He has given it very clearly. Hasye madhuryam ojaha cha. How? Shringara angataya. Each rasam, there is a rasa utpatti where from Shringara you have hasyam, biram bhayanakam, karunam. Solluma, you know that? The rasa utpatti. I don't remember that clearly. So for now, we will take it like this. So hasyam is an anga for shringaram. So shringara angataya madhuryam prakrishtam. So there is more of madhuryam in it. Vikasa dharmataya, because there is a vikasam where your face, when you laugh, there is a blooming of that face. And then there is an ojas also there. So you have a mix of equal mix of both madhuryam and ojas in hasirasam. In Bhayanakarasam, you have more of ojas and less of madhuryam. Very interestingly, he says, magna chittavritti svabhavatve api. Even though the chittavritti is magnam. Magnam means when Bhayanakam, you feel fear and there is a sankocham. There is an automatic reduction in the number of thoughts that go in you or the actions that you may do voluntarily. In Bhayanakarasam, when you fear, there is immediately a cessation of a lot of chittavritti. That is magna chittavritti svabhavatve api vibhavasya deeptataya. What is that which gives rise to that bhayanakam in you? So when it gives rise to the source of fear should always be something bhayankaram, right? Bhayam karoti iti bhayankaraha. So vibhavasya deeptataya. Then the Alambana Vibhava and the Uddipana Vibhavam, see, everybody need not feel that Veera Rasam when they look at a battlefield. Not necessary. Some people may just feel, you know, I don't want to be in that violent scene. I don't want to go and fight, take up arms. I want to just sit at my home. I'm afraid. So, the Vibhavam is Deeptattvam. There is a Prajwalatvam there. So, Ojav Prakrishtam, Madhuryam Tsu, Alpa, Bhayanake. You're not going to be afraid if you see a spring, a blooming flower or a creeper filled with flowers. There, so madhuryam can never become a vibhava, right? Or madhurya nishta, shringara vibhava cannot become a vibhava for bhayanakam. Whereas viram and all can happen, right? Bibatse api bhayanakavat. The same way, anything that gives rise to disgust, also there is a deeptatvam there. There is something that agitates your mind and gives rise to that the arvarup. Well, yeah, it has to be instigated by something. So there should be a bhayankaratvam associated with the vibhava, which incites that bibatsam in you. So for bibatsam also, there is more of ojas and very little bit of madhuryam. Madhuryam is... It can be very less, like maybe in shlokas like Naristana Bharanabhidesham, when still there is more of ojas there than madhuryam. Shante ojaha madhuryam cha. It depends. Now here, vibhava vaichitrayat, based on what gives rise to that rasam in you, vibhava vaichitryat kadachit ojaha prakrishtam kadachit madhuryam prakrishtam. So this is your conclusion and the placement of gunas with respect to each rasam. Next he moves on to dosham. We'll deal that next week. Okay.